game last night. Is it the old story? You kind of looked at it last night and appreciated it to some extent, and then woke up today and went, next is Columbus?
Yeah, I think that's part of our process is to not get too high off the wins or too low off when you don't win. I think we're consistent with how we look at the game, what our process is in communicating the next day with our playing group. And, you know, I thought today was a good day. We had a good meeting. We got our legs moving out on the ice today and used it as almost a pregame skate for tomorrow. We know that this team that we're going to play is going to play us tough. They have historically. And they're going to give us everything they can tomorrow. So we better be ready, and that started with a good day today.
I've said it all year in my interviews. It doesn't matter who we're playing. We're focused on our game, especially this time of year. You're trying to build, and like I said, it doesn't matter who we're playing. We're trying to get to our game every day, and it's consistency what matters. So it doesn't matter who we're playing. We're just trying to play our game.
You talk about being ready for tomorrow. Yeah. Early start, 10:30 Edmonton time. How do you get off to a good start tomorrow and make sure that that can happen?
Well, I think our start tomorrow started today by making sure that we had a good day today. We have an understanding of who the opponent is, what they bring to the table. I also think that this is probably our sixth or seventh early start on the year. So this is nothing new for us. It's just one of the oddities of the schedule. And you know, I think our team is up to the challenge.
I want to ask you about Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, 600 career points and 12 years with the same team. What is it kind of like to see a guy who's been able to lay down roots like that with a single team?
Yeah, he's an elite player and an elite guy in our dressing room. It's fun to watch him kind of as a teammate now and see how he carries himself day in and day out. He's a special guy, a special player. And I think it speaks volumes that he's been with one team for so long because he's so valuable. So I know he's a good friend of mine. He's a great player.
Yeah, I mean, I've been lucky to be part of this group for a long time and play with some great players. And do it on a night like this and where everybody's just flying and we have just a great 60 minutes. And Stu's kicking back there for us. It is a lot of fun to do it with this group.
Longest serving Oiler for a reason, I might add. He's a high-end player. What a lot of people might not know about him off the ice is that he's competitive in anything that he does, whether it's playing a game of golf, playing ping pong. You know, he's somebody who takes pride in his competition level. And I think that's what we're seeing this year is how competitive Nuge is being. In all situations, I'm moving him all over the lineup. He's left wing, he's center, he's playing on first unit penalty kill, first unit power play. He's somebody that, you know, I think got a little bit of a taste of a longer playoff run last year, and he's driven to help the team in whatever way he can make the playoffs first and then go on a long run.
Were you surprised at all that his 600th point came on a low blocker side wrist shot?
No, I thought it was a great shot. I thought, you know, it was a great play. Connor set him up nicely and, you know, posting in, that's kind of his signature. So it was a good shot and important goal at the time for us.